Hello, hello. I'm doing well.
It's great to have you here.
Thanks for having me
here. We're all very excited to have him in the house, aren't we?
Good to see you.
Yeah. Let's hear it for Logan.
Cool.
So you were just at the Halo Awards, I hear, this weekend.
I was. I went back to see some of the Nick family I hadn't seen in a while.
Yeah, so how was that? I was going to ask. So you were in Big Time Rush, just to give some context.
Right, right.
Huge show on Nickelodeon.
Did that for a while.
Nick Cannon is there, all the crew. Was there any, like, OMG moments, or did you see any familiar faces?
It was a lot of behind the scenes where all the people that helped us push the project before were there, and that was cool to kind of say hello and thank you, and I'm sorry for anything that we may have put you through, but no, it was all good. It was all just like old friends again. And the Halo Awards are all about kind of promoting young talent who are helping their communities and people around the world. So that was dope.
Yeah, it's always such a good cause and a great message.
Absolutely.
All the time.
Yeah.
So the show ended.
Kelly Clarkson was there.
Oh, beautiful.
She's killing it.
With her new album come out, didn't it, just recently?
Yeah, I think so.
Amazing.
She's killing it.
I've never met her, but I hear she is legitimately like the nicest person.
She's the sweetest, yeah.
So 2014 was when the show ended, right? Or 2013?
Big Time Rush. Oh, you know better than I do.
I think it was by 2013.
It's a blur.
According to my research.
Yeah, okay.
So, like, have you seen any of the Nickelodeon crew since then? Like, was there a whole, like, geez, everyone's really grown up?
Yeah, none of us,
back to high
none of us
kind of feel.
Have grown up. That's for sure. But I saw Steven recently.
Okay.
Because he does comedy shows a lot, so I always go and hang out with him over at the Improv. I saw Kendall recently for his birthday, mm-hmm. and Dustin, and James and Carlos I had not seen in a while. James is busy. He's all over the place. But he just moved back to Venice, which is pretty close to my house, so okay. I'll probably go and see him and bother him pretty soon. See, Carlos is in Hawaii, so unless I go on vacation pretty soon.
But that's
soon,
what
I'm
social media is for. There's no excuses these
yeah,
days.
Yeah, true.
No need to.
True.
You can FaceTime him.
We keep up with each other.
It's always good to stay in touch.
Absolutely.
I'm sure there was an absolutely incredible bond, I mean, formed over those few years.
Oh, like brothers. We know each other inside and out. Yeah.
So before we talk about your new music, which obviously we're really going to dive into, just like tell me a little bit then about the background of, like, for you, was it always that you wanted to be a singer? Was it acting first, or what came first?
It was acting in the beginning. First it was I need to get the hell out of Texas and go do something fun. But after that, it was going for acting, and then music kind of found me while I was out in LA, and it just took over my life.
So
I had done music back in Texas, but I'd never really... It was just like singing and songwriting to me. It was no big deal. I was just always singing and always writing.
Yeah.
So I guess other people noticed it, but for me...
You're like,
just,
everyone does this, right?
Yeah, it was normal. It was normal for me. But not until I moved out to LA was I really like, I want to do this forever.
Okay. So you knew before you were in Big Time Rush that you wanted to do singing?
It was
or
kind
was
of
it
while,
because that
while I was going into Big Time Rush, I started to kind of uncover a few things and thought, I think I'll keep on doing this.
So how did it all just, you're making it sound so easy. It's like, hey guys, everyone just moved to LA.
It's not easy.
It took a Nickelodeon show
yeah.
and then have an awesome band that tours the world. So what were the steps then? So you moved there when you were about 18, did you?
Yeah, 17 going on 18.
Okay. With your family or by yourself?
By myself.
So like, what did your parents think of that?
They said, they supported me always. My parents are amazing, but they said, you have to get a job. And I was like, okay.
So what was your first job?
First job out in LA was Jamba Juice.
Nice.
Yeah.
Keeping it healthy.
Keep
a lot
healthy,
of people say like Domino's or Subway or whatever it is, but you're like Jamba Juice.
It was Jamba Juice.
Okay.
It was good. I didn't know how to make any of the drinks too fast. So that was a problem. That was definitely a problem. But after...
You were too nimble in the Jamba Juice kitchen.
Yeah, I was really good at drinking everything.
Wow, you could be like a juice model then.
Yeah, exactly.
Guys, look how easy it goes down.
Totally. So after I got the Big Time Rush audition, and it was like 2-year audition process, I had stopped that and just focused full time. Yeah, it was a long time.
So during the 2-year audition process, were you like auditioning for other things? Was that like...
They wouldn't allow me to. So actually, no, I was just kind of hanging out and working on music and acting and all that stuff.
How
and having fun with my friends.
Were
that was like right the time when you first moved out from your parents and you're like, I'm just going to go rage.
Yeah, so you made all
crazy.
Your new friends.
Yeah, yeah. So
I guess the audition going on for 2 years was kind of like a good excuse to be like, you know what, I've got this. You know, this is still going. I'm still working on my acting, but now I can just live my life.
Absolutely,
well.
Yeah.
So it was like guilt-free partying.
Nah, kind of. I still kept it pretty good, but...
Yeah, you're only 18.
Truth.
Gotta keep it PC.
Truth.
Gotta keep it legal. So in 2 years then, like, how many auditions were there? And like, when they started saying, hey, like, you have to sing and dance too, was that something that you were a bit iffy over at the start, or did you just take
it? I mean, I love trying new things, but yeah, the dancing wasn't first and foremost in my head. It wasn't like, oh, sweet, let's do this.
So you were basically the Zayn Zayn Malik in One Direction, he was the same.
It might have been closer to that.
He almost dropped out of X Factor because he couldn't dance.
Yeah, we had a conversation about it, actually, whenever we were on tour with them. And we both were like this. We both kind of got it.
Wait,
like,
how did that conversation go? So you're like, we just knew that we didn't. Stuff.
Yeah, we talked about it. He's like, luckily, we don't have to do that much anymore. And I was like, well, good for you. Yeah, good for you, because I'm going to be out there right now going to do a little dance. So
wait, all the moves for Big Time Rush were really intense then, were they?
They were intense enough. Yeah, okay. It was a lot.
Does it ever get easier?
It does now.
Okay.
Yeah.
But how much dancing would you do in your performances now that you're solo?
It's not like a whole lot of dancing.
Yeah.
I like movement. I like being able to do my own thing. But it's, again, it's more what I was raised on was rock and roll and blues and country and rap. And it just was never dance in my head. Although I love dancing. It's just not that. Now it's not with three other guys.
Yeah. And you don't have to keep up and keep it. Like, totally. It must be so hard to divide your attention between the choreography and getting it so on the ball and then obviously your vocals. Like, does it get to the stage where it is like reflex, like riding a bike?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Because we rehearse all the time.
Yeah.
It was always the biggest thing for us. But after rehearsal, you start to kind of get it in your body and it's like second nature.
Okay. That's good to hear.
Yeah.
So it wasn't too tough in the end of the day.
Exactly.
So the show ended and then the band broke up. Did the band have to break up because the show ended? Because, I mean, it was like...
We were all kind of growing creatively. And I think it wasn't so much of a breakup. It was just each one of us wanted to do our own thing. Yeah. I was really heavy into the music that I was vibing to. And I had grown out of the music that I was making at the time. And I had kind of grown out of the idea of what we were doing. And so it was important for me to be able to spread my wings and do the things I wanted to creatively and kind of the stories that I had.
Yeah. So you'd gotten to the stage where you wanted to go solo, where you were at least thinking about it.
Yeah, absolutely.
So then in terms of like what you learned through that time, because it was so intense, like
it was. It 24/7
with these guys, your whole life completely different. Like what did, from that time, how did you grow and what did you learn that you bring now into being a solo artist? The biggest lessons or...
Yeah, there's so many lessons. You have to imagine if you're hanging out with people on that level, you get to learn a lot about yourself and about how you work with people and everything. But I think hard work was always something that all four of us were really strongly into and something that kept us going, and being able to have patience and kind of saying, you know, I'm going to do whatever I want to do and no matter what anybody else is doing. So that always helped.
And then in terms of like, you know, they always say like, when you get your first job in an office, it's like you really have to learn the office politics.
Right.
So does that sort of thing, like with music and with the industry, what are the kind of things that you're like, oh, I really shouldn't have done that? Or these, it's like music industry 101. If someone was going into it, what are some things that they really would need to know about how to handle themselves or how to behave?
I get to have a quick temper every now and again.
Okay, so that's like allowed?
Every now and again.
Okay.
So that's not allowed.
Okay.
That's something that you should go, probably shouldn't do that. I mean, I keep it pretty cool for the most part, but those are kind of the things that you wish, I should have probably not done that. Probably just slow down a little bit.
Keep the emotion. Or even if you're a creative person, though, I guess that comes with
totally,
it.
Totally.
That's my excuse. I'm like, I'm allowed.
Yeah,
I'm
do
creative.
Whatever I want.
I can have a fit. It's fine. Yeah. So you took a few years. Were you writing the new music during that time, or did you take some time
I was
to
starting
just decompress?
To. And I was starting
what happened?
To. And a lot of the stuff that I was going through on tour and just in life were things that I was already setting myself up to write for, things I wasn't able to do whenever I was in the band. So it was important for me to actually be able to say what I wanted for the first time. And they were already starting to happen while we were on tour.
Okay. Yeah. What were some of those things?
Well, there's music coming out, but relationships were a huge part of it. Being stuck and kind of feeling alone. And, you know, when you're on tour, you're with the same people. You don't feel like you're connected to anybody. You feel like you hit ruts and you hit slow points in life. And so writing was always one of those things that helped me get out of those spots.
Those were the
things.
Like, loneliness is a funny one, because like I remember when I moved here first, a friend said, like, New York is so busy and so many people, but like you feel so lonely.
Yeah.
And I was like, no, like how? How is that possible? Like, it's so busy. There's always something to do. But like, there's something.
Were you popular? You moved here. You were like, I got tons of friends.
Like, I was like this Irish girl about town. Loves new friends.
I think Irish is easy. You make friends so easy.
Well, I mean, there's so many. Yeah, there's like little Irish subcultures everywhere. But I guess there is with every culture here.
And like, you go out drinking and you're just like, yeah.
But now this is not about me. It's about you.
Yes.
So in terms of that, like with so many fans and so many many people in your world. Like, what? How was it lonely?
You're not around people. When on tour, you get into the same routines, and you don't see people for months, and that's stressful on relationships, whether it's with a loved one or with friends, with family even. And it's just important it's important to keep those connections and have people around you who keep you grounded.
Yeah.
Because you can slide off the rails real easy. So it's hard. It was one of those things I had to learn how to maneuver, and I'm sure I'll have to learn it again.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was hard.
And how long did it take then when everything ended, when the band ended, to feel like normal again? Or do you ever?
There's some parts of it that seem very out there, and I kind of leave it as more of like a dream.
Yeah.
Yeah, some parts that that's not real life, or I'll tell my sister or tell my family. What do you think about that? I was like, I don't want to think about it. It's just make believe.
Totally different life that happened.
Yeah, very much.
So that's all the past, completely covered. I feel we went in very deep.
We did.
There.
We got some.
Current music, we have got "Speak of the Devil," which actually was released. Well, the lyric video was anyway, the eve of Halloween, and it's quite eerie. The lyric video, was that a coincidence or did you plan that?
It kind of goes along with the song. I felt like, and the guy who designed it is a good friend and such a talented guy. So he said, "I did one for your last song. Do you want me to do one for "Speak of the Devil"?" I was like, without a doubt, go for it.
So what's the story behind this song? Because it looks kind of like, this is very sensual, kind of film noir-esque.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like a bit Sin City.
What's it is a little story? Sin City.
Yeah.
The story, I don't talk too much about the songs, or I don't love to talk about it because a lot of it is just how the story
is. Because
it's
hard, that's why.
That and the story is meant for everyone else to kind of figure out and make their own idea about it. But it's about a relationship. The good, the bad, and the ugly. And it's kind of meeting one of those people that makes you forget about everything that you believed in at one time. It's that powerful of a relationship.
Okay. And are you going to be dropping a music video for it anytime soon?
We're not sure yet.
Okay. That's still
We're
planning.
Not sure yet. Yeah, we're
but
still
But you
planning.
Do have the music video for Bite My Tongue.
Yes.
Which people love.
That was a lot of fun.
It's so cinematic.
Yeah.
Loads of questions about that. So first of all, it was shot in London, right?
Yep.
Tell me about, have you been in London before? Was that your first time there?
Yeah, we had been in London and we'd done some shows in London.
Okay, yeah.
It just seemed like the right choice. I had an idea for the video and the director, Shasinski. We talked it over and we wanted something that had old architecture but still felt very current, very new and modern. And London was just a go-to place. There were some other options and after weighing out everything, we just thought, we got to do it in London. London's just like, one
and
of
who
the
doesn't
coolest
love
spots.
London?
Yeah, and I was
You're
like, I think I need a vacation.
Go.
Yeah.
So how long did you stay?
We stayed for a couple weeks the first time. And then whenever we were shooting, we were a block away from the bridge attack when that happened.
Oh, wow.
So it was a tough time for everyone.
So there was a bit of time taken.
It was a little scary. So we shut down the production because we were really, really close. And
so how far away were you?
About a block away from where stuff was happening.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Yeah, and luckily all of us were safe. But
wait, so does that must really put a reality check on everything as well?
It was very odd. At the very end of the night, everybody was weirded out by it, without a doubt.
Yeah.
It's really sad in general.
Awful.
So we talked it over and thought, should we finish the video or should we just leave it alone? And everybody thought that, why don't we finish it and show how beautiful London really is? And I thought, that's exactly what we need to do.
Yeah, it does look very stunning, actually, in the video.
Yeah, it's beautiful. The city is beautiful. The people are beautiful. It was really cool.
So Bite My Tongue, I mean, I'm sure you've been asked about it. It's about like not saying something that you want to say.
Bite My Tongue
is
about having that person in your life that encourages you to tell the truth and encourages you to be your truest self and be the person you want to be. Because I think most of the time, or every now and again with me, it's like, I shouldn't say this. I shouldn't do this. And then you have people who are like, no, you
should. Is that the Nickelodeon in you, though?
No, I think that's just...
Is that the conditioning?
No, I've got different moods. Sometimes I'm very shy and I don't talk a whole lot. And other times, you know, it's like, shut up.
Other times I just say
whatever. Other times it's like, why did you say that? Damn.
But be true to yourself.
Absolutely.
I've seen on social media, actually, you've tweeted a lot about that, like, be true to who you are and quotes around that area. Why?
It's very important. I put it out there because I'm talking to myself as well.
So how does someone do that? What would you say if someone came to you like,
in
I
what
just
part?
Feel like I'm living a fake life?
Well, I've had a lot of people that say that, or I want to do this, but no one else thinks I should. I think you have to really believe in yourself and what you're doing. And you'll know at the times where I go, I'm not really feeling it, then it's not something that I should be doing. You have to really listen to yourself and take time to be quiet and figure out really what you want to do. And you usually point yourself in the right direction, or at least it has been for me.
And it's a blessing then to have keen intuition.
Like, yeah,
it's something
absolutely.
That people's thoughts, like, you can kind of like smother yourself with your thoughts that you can't even feel or hear your intuition.
Yeah, absolutely.
So have you been intuitive your whole life, or is it only
I would say so.
Years?
I would say so. I've always had good time to spend by myself and always really valued my alone time and traveling and doing things on my own. And I think that has always encouraged me and helped me grow.
Would you get strong gut instincts about things?
I don't know. I have a lot of weird dreams. So I get a lot of stuff about music and acting and relationships and life and where I should be headed.
Kind of
so.
Like premonitions.
Absolutely.
Can you tell us any?
One was starting this project altogether and really putting it out. I think it took me a while to go, do I really want to put this out for everybody, or is it just going to be for me? And I had a moment, some special moment that kind of let me know you're on the right track, put it out. Show people what's going on. And I think little by little, I show people a little bit more.
Yeah.
Due to myself, I'm very private. A lot of the music is secretive too, but little by little, we keep on.
But for
forward.
Someone who's an artist, it's so nice to share that with the world.
Yeah, absolutely.
You'll keep it to yourself, but the world is hungry for that kind of thing.
Yeah, absolutely. And a lot of people give a lot, but for me, it's just different.
Yeah. Little by little, as you said.
Yeah.
So we've heard three songs.
Three songs.
Is that indicative of what the Logan Henderson sound will be? Because they're quite different.
They are different. That's kind of how I am. I'm all over the place, and I've got all sorts of different personalities. So I like to let that show in the music. Some people stick to whatever they think is right for them, and this is just right for me.
Well, the great thing about the industry nowadays is it seems that no one has to stick to one genre.
Absolutely.
So aren't
we capable of so much? Like everyone in here, we have so much more to us than people know just by the first, you know, blink of an eye. So that's something that I want to do with my music.
Keep everyone guessing.
And keep it fun and interesting. If I'm getting bored, then everybody else will be too. So I just try to make it as, like, whenever I'm in the studio, this one, I was scared about this one.
Why?
It's not the normal vibe. What was in there, it was one of those songs that kind of scares you. You're scared about what you're saying. You're scared about how the music is in general, how the composition is. And I was like, okay, we're on the right track. Let's do it.
Yeah, because you got to do things that scare you. That's the whole, it's the age-old thing, like, push yourself out of your comfort zone.
Yeah,
or if you're the smartest
absolutely.
Person in the room, you're in the wrong room.
Exactly.
I always love that one.
And you're the smartest person in this room. So.
No, I don't know now. I'll say you are, and that would mean we should both walk out, and that would not make a good ending to the interview.
Mic drop.
At all. Should we end it there just for dramatic purposes?
Absolutely, yeah.
I don't know. I have so many other questions. Really quick, though, then, in terms of, like, what's ahead. I know if you've decided whether is there an album or what's going to happen in 2018. Are there people that you really want to work with?
Yeah, I'm working with some of them, but there's a lot more people that I want to work with, not just on my project, but on their projects.
Yeah.
And tour is something that I want to do. If you guys show up, then we'll put one out.
Are you committing to the Logan Henderson tour?
Let's do it.
Are you going to be front row? So it's all ahead.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then one thing I find interesting before you wrap is the climate for the boy bands. Because, like, I was thinking about it, and I know there's, like, two rising boy bands now that are, like, Why Don't We? And Pretty Much.
Yeah, right.
But who else? Like, I mean, how does the climate now?
I don't know. I don't really listen to that music, so I'm not super familiar.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I think they're doing their own thing. I think it's hard. We had kind of our phase with boy bands.
Right, because back five years ago is kind of when it, like,
absolutely.
Was really the prime time.
Yeah.
What's hot now then? Who do you think it's the prime time for? Solo artists or whether it's, like, collaborations?
I don't know. Collaborations are huge right now.
Yeah.
Is it not, like, some of our best songs out are with, you know, great collabs? And so I love to see that. I don't know, solo, even, like, Khalid with his stuff and being able to do a song with Marshmello and hit another song with whoever. That's pretty special. It's neat to see that.
Yeah,
growth.
It's so nice to see such mixing of genres. Like,
yeah.
It's like a few years ago, you never would see, like, Selena and Marshmello.
Yeah, this just doesn't,
like,
fit.
Yeah.
It's like, why not? Who said?
So it's exciting times.
Absolutely.
Who are one or two producers then that you'd really, really love to work with?
As far as just an artist right now, I'd said SCA, but there's some more alternative stuff that I'm listening to, like Nothing But Thieves. That I really love. Who else am I listening to? I have it on my phone. I've just been, like, look at all like, my Spotify
like
playlists.
Would you be like a Billboard chart person, or would you go Spotify Discover? Like, how do you find what you like?
I listen to the smaller artists, the less known. Yeah. It's just what I'm into. I love it all, but I think that's when some of the more magical and a little more to the left. Yeah. I like that kind of sound. And so,
it's kind of like, it almost feels truer because you know there's not as many clips.
Yeah, you keep it cozy and you don't have any pressure of having to go somewhere with it. You can just release a song and think, this is cool. Let's just do this.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I think we have some questions from the audience.
All right, cool.
Hi there.
Hey.
So you were recently at the Nickelodeon Halo Awards.
Yeah.
What was that experience like?
It was cool. Like I said, I was able to see all of my old friends, meet some new friends. And
family reunion.
Pretty much a family reunion. And that stage was crazy. They put on like this huge stage. And so I was able to have a little fun, did some dancing, and just kind of hang out. It was really nostalgic for me. It was nice.
Dancing where? Backstage?
No, it's like, well, the backstage around is kind of the only stage they have. It's like one big spot.
Oh,
so
okay.
Dance your way through the crowd.
Did you ever get starstruck?
Not a whole lot. Yeah. I'd never been like that. Not really starstruck, no. There's people that I love to see. We ran into Red Hot Chili Peppers at lunch, and I was like, this is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Cool to see Anthony Kiedis.
When it's like flee. Idol status.
Then absolutely.
Like, just to see someone in the flesh. It's not like you'd be like, it's more like, wow, there they are.
Well, great music and stuff that I listened to when I was young get me through all my terrible days at school. Like, that's the kind of music, that's the kind of stuff that is special for me.
Yeah. I think we have another question. Hi.
Hi, Logan. How are you?
Hey, good. How are you?
I'm all right, thanks.
Cool.
Well, moving on from Big Time Rush and having your own sound now, I was just curious, where do you pull inspiration from and how did you find your sound?
Good question. Inspiration comes at some of the most random times and the weirdest times. Listening to all sorts of different music, traveling, I usually get a lot of inspiration from, and then meeting new people and talking with them. A lot of the songs I have are very much about my life, and then other parts of that song are very much about other people's lives that I've drawn from and talked to them about, which is cool. And then, like I said, a lot of my alone time, we never turn off and allow ourselves to think and be patient, just kind of have our own thoughts. And sometimes that's hard, but that's sometimes my most favorite times and where I get most of my inspiration from. Yeah.
So you said travel. Where is the most inspirational place then? Is there one place that you're like, wow, this has given me a lot of material?
Yeah.
Where?
It's weird, like sometimes the opposite from where California is always sunny, it's always good weather. So I like even going to Vancouver or going to Canada or somewhere like that where it's rainy and it's dreary, but there's a lot of still emotion, you know, whenever you go to those places.
I was actually listening to an interview with Rivers Cuomo from Weezer, and he said the same thing. He's like, usually he lives in the warm climates, and he lives in California, right?
I think so.
And he went, I think he lived like in New York or somewhere else, and he's like, you can hear the like the harshness and the coldness and everything on the whole entire album.
Yeah, that's some of my favorite times. I mean, I love Sao Paulo and going to Brazil and stuff like that, but it's a different vibe.
Yeah.
It's a different feel whenever you're by the beach and that kind of stuff. But I like going anywhere. I just love traveling.
Yeah.
Getting on a plane, just going somewhere.
And I mean, it's for work.
Yeah.
You're like, I need to write another album. Bring me on a tour around the world.
Yeah.
It's a good reason.
Yeah.
And one final question.
Right here.
Hey, what's up?
So growing up, you said you listened to a lot of rock and roll and rap. Are there any artists that you particularly, like, you know, stood out to you that you listened to a lot? At that time?
This isn't even rock or rap, but Elliott Smith was one that I always listened to.
Yeah.
Love his songwriting. Who else? Queen was always a big one. Always love that. My dad always listened to like B.B. King and like blues stuff, like Eric Clapton, and my sister really loves old jazz, so I'd always listen to that in the car. So pretty eclectic throughout the whole family. We listen to a little bit of everything, or as much as I can get my hands on. Yeah.
So it was a mixed bag.
All over the place. I love music.
Well, Logan, thank you so much. And best of luck with the year to come, and hopefully we'll hear some other new songs as well soon.
Yeah, thank you, Bill,
Thanks,
for having
Logan.
Me.
Thanks, Logan. Bye.